greetings to all viewers and listeners. At this time, we would be blessed with our opening prayer by Brother Lee.
Heavenly Father, we call on your name this evening as we do this broadcast. I pray, Lord, that you will come into our midst in the person of your Holy Spirit, and those who listen will be edified and will come to know you, whom to know is life eternal. This is my humble prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Brother Lee, for that very deep and inspiring prayer. I pray that our viewers and listeners have been blessed. And now we'll have our theme song by Sister Mabel.
Encamped along the hills of light, ye Christian soldiers rise, and praise the battle ail the night, shall veil the growing skies. Against the foe in veil below, let all our strength be held. Faith is the victory we know that overcomes the world. Faith is the victory. Faith is the victory. Oh, glorious victory that overcomes the world.
Thank you, Sister Mabel, for singing so beautiful. I pray that our viewers and listeners can connect with Christ, our Lord and Savior, through that lovely singing. And now I'd like to welcome our viewers and listeners to the Faith Empowered program being brought to you by the Loving Heart Advent Ministry. We pray to assist you to understand the issues that confront mankind today. And I pray that if you never had faith, or even if you lost your faith, may Faith Empowered empower you to connect with Christ, our Lord and Savior. And now, I'd introduce our panel of those taking part in our program. We have Sister Mabel, who sang our opening song and is co-hosting our theme song, and Brother Lee, who did our opening prayer and would be doing our Bible study. And we have also our dear sister Constance, who will be doing our health feature. And doing our special item would be our dear brother Kenny and sister Franklin, the Franklin duo. And I pray that our viewers would be blessed and be able to connect with Christ, our Lord and Savior, and be saved when he comes again. And I'd like to remind our viewers that we are here for you. If you need prayer for any issue, feel free to call us on 07-951-745-003. And if you need further information on our Bible presentation, feel free to write to lovingheart.co1@gmail.com. And I pray that as you continue to listen and you tune in, you would be blessed. And at this time, we would be blessed with our health feature. Previously, we have done garlic, we have done beetroot, and now, today, we would learn more about a wonderful herb our Savior and Lord has created for us, and that is garlic, which our dear sister would expound to us.
Good evening, everyone. It's a pleasure to present the health feature for today. And I'm going to address a very important, very loving herb which is mostly found in kitchens across the world. And this is garlic. Garlic is a herb coming from the onion and leek family and equally chives. It's been used for centuries in Greek culture and Egyptian culture to improve enhancements and performance. But mostly garlic is known for its effect on the heart and blood vessels. Garlic produces a chemical called allicin, which is responsible to give garlic this strong odor. Garlic has been found to be good in the treatment of osteoarthritis, which is inflammation of degenerative conditions of the hips. It helps a bit. It's been proven also through various researches that garlic also improves testosterone in men, and sperm count is increased by the consumption of garlic, and therefore improves fertility. It also is said that garlic improves erectile dysfunction in men. It stimulates ovulation in women. So this shows that garlic is effective on the reproductive system of both men and women. Garlic is renowned to lessen the hardening of blood vessels, especially the arteries, in conditions which we know as atherosclerosis. Garlic is very well known in some cultures across the world to treat cold, coughs, and sore throat. It is also good to treat a certain infection in the bowels caused by a bacteria called Campylobacter. It's good for treatment of tuberculosis, bronchitis, and during the era of COVID-19, a lot of people found solutions with garlic, and it assisted them together with other herbs. It is said also that garlic is good to relieve pain, especially in a condition called endometriosis, where you've got the lining of the uterus. Some of these are found elsewhere, scattered in the womb, in the tubes, or on the bowels of women, and it gives them a lot of pain and discomfort and inflammation and scarring. So garlic is said to help reduce the pain in this condition called endometriosis, especially if it's taken for a couple of months. It's good to reduce blood sugar, pre-meal blood sugar, and also post-meal blood sugar for people who are diabetics. Garlic is said to relieve also, reduce precisely the level of cholesterol in the blood. So a lot of people take it for that, and if you don't know about it, that's your opportunity to try it out. Not only that, it also helps to treat this condition called fatty liver disease, especially in people who is non-alcoholic. People who eat garlic, they say that it makes them feel strong and healthy. It is also said to be able to treat certain conditions of the gums, where there's a swelling, infection of the gums. And it helps to clear off this infection and allows people to eat better and appreciate their food. It's good also for warts. You just cut a little piece of garlic, rub it on those warts, bandage it a little bit, and once it starts throbbing, you can remove it after a couple of days or within a week, that wart will decrease in size. Garlic has got, however, some side effects. Most people do not like garlic too much because they say it gives them bad breath. Yeah? cause a little bit of heartburn, irritation of the stomach, especially if it's eaten raw. A little bit of gas and sometimes diarrhea. Garlic is said to have an effect on blood thinning. People can have certain reactions to it, causing them to bleed a little bit. Those people who are on anticoagulants or blood thinning medications, they've got to consider with the doctor and take it in moderation. If you apply garlic on the skin for any particular reason, that you have something on your skin, you've got to be careful because garlic can irritate the skin and cause burns. It has got major interactions with certain medications, like those people who are on HIV drugs. That drug, particularly known as sanguinavir, it interferes with its absorption. So there again, you've got to consult with a doctor if you are going to take garlic for a long time. Garlic decreases the absorption of certain drugs, especially isoniazid drugs, which is sometimes used in the treatment and management of tuberculosis. Garlic can cause bruising for people who are already on anticoagulants. Those people who are taking warfarin have got to be very cautious when they take the garlic. And also those who are taking blood pressure medications to lower their blood pressure. Especially also if people are diabetic, they also got to be very cautious with that. People who've had liver transplant or transplant of any organs, they usually have a drug called tacrolimus, and that taking garlic with that can really cause a problem with the absorption of this drug. So you've got always to refer to your doctor for that. Garlic is a very good herb. It's been used for centuries in the kitchen. It's inexpensive. Everybody can get access to it. It treats many ailments, but it has little side effects that I've passed on briefly. We just want to thank God for allowing us to have such a wonderful herb, which is good to soothe our ailments, treat us, and we give glory to Him. Thank you.
Amen.
Thank you, Sister Bernadette. Our first question goes to Brother Lee. What does God design that His word shall be to us in this world of darkness, sin, and death?
Thank you, my dear sister, for that question. And to answer the question, we turn in our Bibles to Psalm 119, verse 105. And it reads thus, and I'm reading from the New King James Version. It says, "Thy word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path." Now, reading the Bible helps us to not to stumble in the darkness, meaning the darkness of this world. And further, in Psalm 119, verse 130, it says here, that the entrance of your word, God's word, gives light. It gives understanding to the simple. So, again, from God's word, we get enlightenment, we get understanding, and we get to know what the scripture is saying. Further, in Proverbs 6 and verse 23, we read, "For the commandment is a lamp, and the law is light." The commandment is a law. For the commandment is a lamp, and the law is light. Again, we go to Psalm 19 and verse 8. It says in Psalm 19 at verse 8. The statutes of the Lord are right, rejoicing the heart. The commandment of the Lord is pure, enlightening the eyes. So when we look into God's word, which is law and light, we can see clearly what we need to see in God's word, what we need to know about God, what we need to know about the word of truth. The Bible clears it up. Now, there was a time in our history, a period called the Dark Ages, when the light of God's word seemed to have been put out. Men tried their endeavor best to eradicate the Bible. But thank God, because God is in control, it didn't last forever. It lasted for 1,260 years, called the Dark Ages. But light again shone forth. And in John chapter 8 and verse 12, and we are searching our Bibles. John 8 and verse 12, it says here, then Jesus spoke to them again, saying, I am the light of the world. He who follows me shall not walk in darkness, but shall have the light of life.
Amen.
As we read said earlier on, that the word of God, like a lamp, enlightens our darkness. So we don't have to stumble along our way. Furthermore, we go to 1 John. Still searching the scriptures, 1 John chapter 5,1 John chapter 5, verse 5 to 7 says, this is the message which we have heard from him and declare to you, that God is light, and in him is no darkness at all. If we say we walk in the light, if we say we have fellowship with him and walk in darkness, we lie and do not practice the truth. But if we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship with him, one another, and the blood of Jesus Christ, his Son, cleanses us from all sin. Now, light symbolizes God's glory and allows truth to be clearly seen.
Amen.
Dear listener, do you want to understand the Bible clearly? Do you want truth to be clearly seen? Then take the time to study, not just read, but study, pray, ask for the aid of the Holy Spirit to help you understand what the Word of God is saying. Because you don't want to continue to walk in darkness. You want to have fellowship with God and with your fellow men. So study the Word of God, and surely you will find the path that leads to eternal life. You will find that your way has been illuminated with the Word of God. And so, darkness hides evil and untruth, but cannot exist where there is light. So, because light illuminates darkness, when light comes, darkness is dispelled. So keep studying, my dear listener. Read the Bible, keep studying, and God will help you to understand clearly what you need to understand in his word.
Amen.
Thank you very much, Brother Lee, for the comforting words of wisdom and knowledge. Jesus is indeed the light of the world.
Amen.
Our second question goes to Sister Bernadette. For what purpose were the scriptures written?
Thanks very much, Sister Mabel, for that question. Yes, and I can find the answer in the King James Version of the Bible. And to find that, we go to Romans 15:4. And it says, "For whatever things were written aforetime were written for our learning, that we through patience and comfort of the scriptures might have hope." Amen. So we see, we have a loving God. He didn't just feel to write and just wrote. There was a purpose. Yes? You say, whatever were written aforetime. So all we see in the Old Testament connects with what's in the New. Amen. It says that we, through patience, yes, patiently going through the scriptures, not hurriedly, but prayerfully, asking the Holy Spirit to guide us as we read, and comfort of the scriptures that we might have hope. You know, when you don't have hope, you get depressed, you get anxious, you get miserable. You live a hopeless life. So you see how important the scriptures are for us. In the world today, so many persons are suffering with depression. So many persons are suffering with mental illness. Why? Because they don't have that hope that the Bible offers. Yes? And we can confirm as we go to 2 Timothy 3:16. It says, all scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness. Yes? So God hasn't left us careless and without knowledge to know right from wrong. And we see doctrine, our fundamental doctrines, the basis or the tenets of which or a religious belief or church is built, we are not having our beliefs done in vain or without solid foundation. It's from the Bible. Yes? And he said it can also teach us what's right and wrong. For it corrects us. It instructs us in righteousness. Amen? Nowhere else can you get that. So you see how important reading the Bible is. Yes? It says that the man of God may be perfect, thoroughly furnished unto all good work. Yes? This perfection comes from Jesus. The perfection of love. Humanly speaking, we don't have it. So we ought to seek and desire all these things that God has for us in the Bible so that we can know His will for us and connect with Him and develop that relationship with Him and be saved in His kingdom when He comes again. Yes, so I want our viewers and listeners not to just listen to me, but to dig deep for themselves and connect with Christ, our Lord and Savior, and be saved in His kingdom when He comes again. Amen.
Thank you very much, Sister Bernadette and Brother Lee, for this lovely and powerful Bible study. I hope that all our viewers and listeners have been blessed. And I pray that you will be connected with Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, and to be saved in His kingdom. Amen. Thank you very much. God bless you all.
Thank you, Sister Mabel. And now we'll be blessed with special music by the Franklin duo.
I will sing, oh Jesus, love,
sing of him who first loved me,
for he left,
bright was above,
and
died on Calvary.
I will sing
of Jesus' love.
Endless praise
my heart shall give.
He has died that I might live.
I will sing his love for me. I will sing.
Nothing good.
How could he such
love bestow? Lord, I own.
My heart is one.
Help me now,
my love to show. My love to show.
I will sing
of Jesus' love.
Endless praise.
My heart shall give.
He has died that I might live.
I will sing his love to me. I will sing his love to me.
Amen. That was so beautifully blended. Amen. Yes. We thank God for that lovely singing by the Franklin duo, by God's grace. We pray that our viewers and listeners have been blessed and would connect with Christ, our Lord and Savior, when He comes again, and be saved when He comes again. And now, I would like to remind our listeners and viewers that we are here for you. If you need prayer for any issue, please feel free to call us on 07-951-745-003 or for further information on our Bible presentation, on our help feature, please email us at lovingheart.co1@gmail.com. And to bring our program to a close, we'll have prayer by Sister Constance. Amen. So this time we'll be blessed with prayer by Sister Constance as we bring our program to a close.
Let us pray. Gracious Father, wonderful God, we thank you so much for providing us with your word, which is a guide to us in our life down here. We thank you so much for the great sacrifice of Jesus Christ. We want to give ourselves to you. We ask you to place your blessing on this program, that the viewers will listen, will ponder, will search for your truth. For you say, we shall know the truth, and the truth will set us free. Set us free, O God. And come into our hearts, we invite you this evening. Prepare us to come again to listen to these wonderful messages. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen.
Amen.
So once again, I want to thank our viewers and listeners for tuning in. And I pray that you would connect with Christ, our Lord and Savior. And keep tuning in, and goodbye, and God bless you. Until our next program.